FN Radio. It's all about what's next. Go to financialsurvivalnetwork.com and sign up for your free weekly newsletter. You'll also get 3 free reports. The Financial Survival Network. It's all about what's next.
And welcome back. You are listening to the Financial Survival Network. It's Carrie Lutz. And if you think the unions can't be beaten, if you think they're productive members of society, well, think again. We've got Dave Bigo with us. He fought the unions and he won. The trend, well, you've seen what's happened with right-to-work laws being passed in numerous states, formerly pro-union states in the country throughout. More is happening now, but they're planning to try to get a lot through in Obama's remaining days of his term. Dave, welcome back.
Well, thank you, Gary. It's always a pleasure.
Likewise. So what have they got up their sleeves now? What are they trying to pull? And how are we going to beat them?
Well, they got a lot of things up their sleeve, Gary. You know, the ambush election that actually went into effect April 14th, and it's kind of been delayed because some lawsuits were passed against it, and those have been knocked down. And I think you're going to see a lot of the unions, because they're so desperate for membership, is to go out and petition for a lot of elections here during the remaining term of the president. And also, you've got the SEIU out there in their fight for 15. You know, this thing that they're saying is for the employees and the workers. They want to make them $15 an hour and that, and which is all just a facade. It's really about the union getting information on them and force unionizing them behind the scenes. And then, you know, the United Auto Workers, they're desperate out there. They're, you know, they haven't been able to unionize down in Chattanooga and in other places in Alabama. And they are really going after the employees down there. And you know, the sad part about all this, Kerry, is this is about the union bosses, the union dues they want for their own pockets and their political agenda. But the really, really sad part is all the intimidation factor and brainwashing that the employees and workers across America are going through because of these people.
Yeah, well, we've seen it over and over again, and really nothing nothing good comes when you join a union these days. I mean, what does the union really do for you in modern America? At this point, Dave, what do they do for you?
Well, and most of them don't. Now, I want to tell you, I'm not totally anti-union. In fact, I worked for a company that, you know, I turned around plants were failing that were all unionized plants. And in some of the cases, I could understand why you needed unions there. And I can understand across the country why you needed some unions, because there are business people that are don't take care of their people. They don't treat them right. And they abuse them. And you need some representation. But the problem is, Kerry, today it's a very small percentage, and these union bosses, they want to be big, they want to be multimillionaires and have huge corporations instead of doing what they're there for, and that's representing a smaller group of people. And that's what we're seeing out here. These people that you know, basically are saying they're all for the people, and you know, we want to do what's right for American workers, when it's really what's right for them.
Yeah, so what is a union worker to do? If you're already trapped in a union, what can you possibly do about it, Dave?
Well, you can petition for elections, and you know, that a lot of that or decertification, excuse me, and a lot of that is going on. Down in Alabama, there's some people that are in the UAW at NT and Bowser, and they want out of the union, and they voted the union out on 3 different votes, and the UAW will not back away. They keep filing lawsuits that something's gone wrong, that you know, we need to do it again, and all this. They're so desperate to keep these people unionized, and this is the sad thing. And but I have to say this, there have been people in other parts of the country, the employees have gone in and asked for a decertification, and they voted against the union, and the unions are gone. And you're seeing more and more of that, because the union members are tired of the union bosses and their tactics.
So decertification, you petition for decertification, and by law, they're required to hold an election?
Right. And then they hold an election, and it's like the one in Alabama that I was just talking about. The UAW lost in that election 82-50 at NT and Bauer. And still, they won't back away. They're trying to fight and, file petitions that the election was fraudulent or whatever, because they don't want to give these people their freedom. And it's sad what's going on in this country right now, Kerry.
It really is. I mean, you're supposed to have freedom. They want you to have freedom to have an abortion, or freedom of this, freedom to not practice a religion. But when it comes to freedom to choose a union, and that you're not allowed to, right? Right?
No. Right. That's exactly right. And that's what's hypocritical about the far left and this administration and the union bosses and that. You know, they'll go after other people saying that they're wrong and they don't do things right and they don't give people justice and freedom of speech, or say whatever it may be, abortion or whatever. But the truth is they will do anything they can to get people on their side and to grow their membership and get votes and do all that kind of stuff. And on the other side of it, they'll do things to run right over these people and take advantage of them.
Yeah, it's not about freedom at all, is it? Does it, Dave?
No, Kerry, it really does not. It's all about them and their own survival. Because as I've written and spoken many times, the unions are dinosaurs. They're heading towards extinction. And, desperate people do desperate things. And they're connected to this administration and some of the very, very far left people. And they'll use any tactics they can, whether it's brainwashing, intimidation, whatever they can to survive.
Yeah. And you, as a member, or if you're not a member, what's the best way to defend against these guys, against these thugs?
Well, I get a big kick out of the gal in my book, Miriam the Mighty. She's a member of the SEIU in California because she works for the state and she has to be a member. But she has lawsuits against the SEIU out there. She's working on decertification out there. And last June, she got 50%, or I think about 50% of her local to vote against the non-germane dues, which is dues that are used for political purposes. And these people now have had their dues reduced by about 40%. That's how much of their dues was going to politics. And she is really getting them stirred up out there. I mean, she's getting people to wake up, and you're seeing that also up in Michigan with United Auto Workers, who helped get Right to Work passed. They were the one getting Right to Work passed. And what you need is people to stand up and not be afraid to go after the union bosses and show some backbone.
Yeah. Well, of course, sometimes easier said than done, because they're not afraid to use threats of violence against you, are they?
No, they're not. And, most of it is they don't go out anymore and really try to hurt anybody. But it's psychological warfare and it's financial warfare. And they just, they'll do subtle things like, we know where you live. If you don't come along to our side, we know where you live. And this is the type of thing you see going on a lot. And then they do things with businesses to try and cost them a lot of financial pressure so that the businesses just give in and give up and say, okay, you can just unionize our people.
Yeah, which can be very effective, that psychological warfare, can it?
Well, yes, it can. And so can the financial part, because I know, we fought the SIU. We spent close to $1 million just in attorney fees alone. And, most companies won't do that. And on top of it, you got all your other costs involved with your workforce and that. And I've had many, many businesses tell me that they just would not go through it. It's easier just to give in and say, where do you want me to sign? You can force unionize my people.
Mm-hmm. Do you know any company out there, Dave, that's had a positive experience with unionization?
Well, not that I've heard recently, which is really sad, because, like I say, I know places that businesses that they deserve to have a union, but it just seems like the tactics and the ultimate goals of the unions, and mainly because they're what I call big labor anymore. They're not the local unions that really care about the employees and are trying to help the local situation. And I'll give you an example. I was making a speech a couple of years ago down in southern Indiana, and when I got done, A couple guys came up to me, and you could tell they were retired. And they said, Mr. Bego, I want you to know we were union members here in town, and we listened to you, and everything you say is true. We helped get the union started in this town because the company we had, the business owner and them, were not nice people. But as it grew and went along, the national union came in and took over our union. And all the demands and everything that they put on the company forced the company to close down because it wasn't making any money. And that's what happens when you get the national unions in here versus the local unions. So the point of my story is, when they do what they're supposed to do and they represent the local guys, it works.
Yeah, and the problem is that that they've gotten hijacked.
That's right. That's exactly right. And it's getting worse and worse as these people go out there and are trying to survive across the country. And people like the SEIU are perfect examples of it.
Yeah. And there was a time when the government would really go after them, when they were really gangsters and using violence and intimidation and threats. But government seems to be on their side now. It's different, different now.
Yeah, they are, and it's all about votes. And you know, I hate to say it's just the Democratic Party, but that's where 90% of the union money goes for politics. But I know a lot of Democrats that are good people, and I like them. But it's really the far left, progressive, radical side that is causing all this. And Kerry, my concern is that the good Democrats are kind of like the conservatives right now. They don't have any backbone. They won't stand up and go after these people. They cave into the intimidation factor.
Mm-hmm. And it's really putting the country's competitiveness in jeopardy. It's really costing the country jobs, and it's really distorting the political process as well, because the Democrats know that they've got all these resources automatically lined up behind them. They don't have to do anything. They have all these resources automatically committed to their campaigns. They don't have to do anything for these people, right?
That's right. The Democrats know they got that behind them, not just for their money, but for their political ground game, their foot soldiers. And that's the sad part of it. And but getting some of them to realize the Democrats that do have the best interests of people in this country in mind don't have the backbone to stand up against them because of, again, their intimidation tactics and their brainwashing.
Yeah, well, hopefully this is going to change. I think what's happened in the country in the past 6.5 years is a wake-up call to so many people who are formerly once ardent union. Hey, it's happened in the Jewish community. Hopefully it's happened in the African-American community as well. Dave, want to find out more about you, your blog, your book? Where's the best place to go?
They can go to my website, thedevilatourdoorstep.com, and they can read my blog and they get my book there at a discount, or they can go to amazon.com to get the book also.
All right. And as always, you find a link to Dave's site in the show notes to this interview on financialsurvivalnetwork.com. Don't forget, we got our webinar coming up with Rick Rule and John Embry on May 20th. The link will be found on our website, financialsurvivalnetwork.com. Go there. It's free. It's really important that you check it out. We're talking about financial repression, the war on cash, and so many other important topics. Check it out. It's free. Dave, as always, thanks so much for being on.
FSN Radio. It's all about what's next. Go to financialsurvivalnetwork.com and sign up for your free weekly newsletter. You'll also get 3 free reports. The Financial Survival Network. It's all about what's next.